what caused the charge pump drive key to shear off. Prior to seeing the pump, we said that it could either be too much torque with a high charge pressure or too rapid of change of pressure, either rising or falling. The customer agreed that it was believed to be overpressure in the charge circuit. Let's take it apart and investigate the damage.
They are missing their key, and it looks like it ran with missing a key. You'll be able to see that there's lines around the shaft of it actually spinning in a circle. It will hold this in place, and this is actually what spins around, creating the flow of the charge pump. This is the valve block, so your compensator is hooked up into here. This is your indicator. This part will sit in those two things, and when you're on stroke, your swash plate will move, which will actually control this, and it'll let you know what position you're in. That shouldn't be loose. These should be tight, right? You should hear like a crack. It means the customer probably took that indicator off. Gasket, faceplate. These are your pressure tubes. Here's your barrel. This here is your aux shaft. It should come out easy, but it's not. That means something's not good inside. This is your front flange, mounting flange gasket. I always flip it. Thicker tubes. Obviously, if you put it on these tubes, they'll bend. Then they're no good. So that shiny part is part of the shaft seal. This is called the retainer. Retaining ring, shaft, bearing, shim. Really feel for it on the joints. These feel all right. Six thou. It'll be marked with a color. So that color defines the size. So it'll just be your thou differences, which matters for when you do your clearance. When you're rebuilding it, you'll want to see if you have a burr here. That little burr, like right here, that burr will happen when you're taking it apart. So it sit, and as it runs, it'll clean itself up, but now you have 3 thou with the burr. Without the burr, it's 4 thou. It could make a difference on the expectancy, or life expectancy. As well as every time you put a snap ring on and take it off, you need to sand it and then polish it. Same thing for your pistons. You always want to make sure you don't have a burr, because then again, you'll have a bad measurement. And of course, your creep plate too. Chambers, have a look inside, see if it's rough. So your chamber covers will have a rotation marked on it, either clockwise or counterclockwise. All that matters is for how it's set up internally for the passengers. It's good to have this cam and cradle back together the way it was, because it wears itself in and it gets a seal together. So if you flip it, it's kind of going against how its pattern was. So simplest way is just to put a T on each. So now I'm just going to lift it up to see how the oil suction is, just to kind of get a feel. So it could just mean the oil's not dirty, whatever. So I'll take it apart, see if I can feel anything or see anything that looks weird, which I don't. So I'll give it a clean up and put some fresh oil on there. You don't need a gaskets. I just wanted to make sure they all moved freely. They bind up, I mean. So I'm just going to check for wear, which I didn't see in that one. So the problem is you have a step here which doesn't allow that to slide over. It's not supposed to be like that. You're supposed to be able to just pull it right off. Just run my finger inside of it. If I can feel anything bad in there, not a good sign. If I can see some wear, I don't feel it. I'm gonna go put it in there. Just tight.
After Trent's inspection, we did find out that the customer did have the unit apart, which explains why so many of the components were loose. The plan is to replace the creep plate, the faceplate, and the auxiliary shaft, along with a few small parts such as seals, gaskets, and O-rings. Trent will start by cleaning up the pump piece by piece. We have a short linked above that shows the process. Part 2 with the reassembly is coming soon.